Welcome everyone. So today I'm going to show you all a mind-blowing trick with which you can find quadratic equation answers, or you can factorize your quadratic equations literally in just one single step. Okay, so first I'm going to show you a very easy one, and then we are going to go to the complicated ones. Okay, so for this one, see, normally traditionally what you do is you try to factorize this constant in such a way that the two factors which you get, their addition or subtraction should get you the middle term, okay, the term which has x with it. Okay, so here I can say 6 can be divided as what, or rather the two factors which are getting you 6 is 2 into 3, right? So you can write this as nothing but what, x square plus 3x plus 2x plus 6. So then you take x common and then you get x plus 3. Then you take 2 common and then you will again get x plus 3. So eventually your answer will now come out to be what? X plus 3 and x plus 2. Okay. So now the trick which I'm trying to show y'all is nothing but what? You just have to focus on these two numbers. Okay. Now see, here we had what? X square plus 5x plus 6. Okay, so now here we knew that 2 into 3 are the two factors which will get you, whose addition will get you what, 5. So here you could have directly written x plus 3 and x plus 2. Okay, let me change the question for a little bit. Okay, so now imagine if the question was not this, if the question was x square minus 5x minus 6. Okay, so in that case also you could have done the same thing, or if you, it was plus 6, let's do that, not minus 6, plus 6, then you could not take the factors which were what, 2 and 3. Here you will take the factors which are what, 1 and 6, because the subtraction of 1 from 6 will get you 5, but you don't want just 5, you want what, minus 5. So here you will take a minus with 6. Okay, so 1 minus 6 will get you minus 5. So here also your factors now change to what, x plus 1 and x minus 6. So I hope now this particular understanding is very, very clear. Now what happens is, when I showed most of my students this kind of a trick, they got confused when the coefficient of x square is not 1. You have a number over here. So what you have to do is, you just have to multiply this number with your constant. What number you're getting? You're getting the number what? 72. Then again, you will do the job of taking factors. So again, 1 and 72 is the factor, first factor. Then second is what? 2, 36. Then what else we'll get is 3, 24. Then again, we'll get what? 4. 18, then 6 and 12. Okay, then we have again 8 and 9 as well. Sorry, I forgot that. Yeah, so these are the factors. Now students, if you all don't know how to find factors, please understand, to do this trick, your knowledge of factors has to be very, very important. This is of supreme importance. So I'm going to put up a link of that somewhere on the top and at the end of this video also. Please go ahead and check that out, how to find factors of any given number. Okay, now your job is what, to make or to find a combination from where you will get 7. So now if you look closely here, what you get is 8. Oh, sorry, this is 17. My bad. This is 17. So 8 plus 9 will get you 17. Okay, so this is going to get you 17. So now you should again go and do what, x plus 8 and x plus 9. But in this particular answer, you have to remember that you were multiplying this particular number, right? So here also you will divide your answer by 12. Okay, so your final answer will be what, x plus 2 upon 3, because both of them are getting cancelled and they're going in 4's table, and here you will have x plus 3 upon 4. Okay, so this is very important. This, you can leave your answer at this particular point, or if you want, you can take the LCM of individual brackets. So we'll have 3x plus 2 and here you will have 4x plus 3. Either ways, this answer or this answer is absolutely fine. So I hope I'm making myself extremely clear. Now I'm going to show you a case where you will have negatives. Okay, so here we have, again, we'll multiply 6 and minus 4. So you get what? Minus 24. So forget the minus right now. We don't have to be bothered about that. We'll just focus on the finding the factors part. So again, 1 and 24, then 2 and 12, then 3 and 8. Now, see, I can still go ahead, but if you look closely, I get my factors of 5, of this particular number, 5, okay? So now, see, understand, I want a negative 5. I want negative 5. Now, that can happen only when I get what? Minus 8 plus 3. Only then I'll get a negative 5. So here, your factors will be what? X minus 8 and x plus 3. Just don't forget of dividing this coefficient, which is 6. Okay, so your final answer will now be what? X minus 4 upon 3, and this will be x plus 1 upon 2. And you can leave your answer here, or you can also get your answer as 3x minus 4 and 2x plus 1. Either ways, your answer is absolutely correct. So I hope I'm making myself extremely clear. Now see, if you see clearly, in the previous slide, I finished with the plus ones. Both of them were plus. And now we have done with the minus one. So now our time is there for a plus and minus scenario. So here again, 4 into 10, that gets you what? 40. Taking this factors, 1 and 40, 2 and 20, 4 and 10. Then we have 8 and 5. Now again, we see that 8 and 5, when you subtract 8 minus 5, you get the answer as plus 3. Okay. So here again, 4x, sorry, my bad. We don't want that. We just want the factors, right? So we have x minus 5 and x plus 8 upon 4 upon 4. So your, this is your answer, or you can leave it and or you can go one step ahead and you can get 4x minus 5, and here you can get 4x plus 8. Okay, so I hope I'm making myself very, very clear. Now students, for your DIY, I want you to tell me what is the answer, or what are the factors of 3x square plus 7x minus 6. Do let me know the answers for this one in the comment section. And also, if you like the way I'm explaining, then please go ahead and hit the like button, because that literally gives me a lot of encouragement in doing these kind of videos.